we're talking about the concept of power factor. And power factor is important for power transfer when we have power coming from a source to a load. And the power factor itself is defined directly here. It's the real power divided by the amount of apparent power. If we go back to our analogy of the package and Valerie, then Valerie's our real power. So it's the amount of real power, Valerie, over the container. So here's a nice visual way to remember this. And you can think about it as how well does Valerie take up the container that she's put into here. Let's start with the general form for all periodic waves. And this means that the current and the voltage, they could be sinusoidal or they could be a different shape, just square wave or even a DC value. So for general periodic waveforms, let's try to define this in more mathematical terms. So first we'll start with the real power. The real power is the same as the average power. So you would take your P of t, your power in the time domain, and you take an average of that over your period. So for non-sinusoidal waveforms, you have to actually go through and calculate that over a period, and you can find this expression based on normal circuits. The apparent power we haven't really discussed yet, but the definition is actually very simple. It is the RMS value of the current multiplied by the RMS value of the voltage. So whether you have sinusoidal or some other waveform, you can find the RMS value of the current, multiply that by the RMS value of the voltage waveform, and that's your apparent power. So this is the full definition. Once you find your average value and you know the RMS values of your current and your voltage, that is your definition. For general periodic waveforms, it may take a little bit more calculation, but this is where you start. For sine waves, we can do the same approach. And by sine wave, we mean the voltage and the current are both pure sinusoidal waveforms. They may have a phase shift between them or they may not, but they're both sine waves. To calculate that, we can start from the same approach. And the real power is, if you remember, we defined it with the power triangle as P. Draw the power triangle down here real quick. Remember, this is our P, our Q, reactive power, and our S. S is actually a vector, so we'll be looking at the magnitude of it. Here's the equation. Power factor is equal to the power over the magnitude of our apparent power. And if we go through and we calculate that for sine waves, we will find that power becomes the RMS voltage, the RMS current times the RMS voltage times the cosine of the phase shift between the voltage and the current. The magnitude of the apparent power is actually just the same as up here. So it's going to be the RMS value of the current and the voltage. We see from this equation that these will cancel the RMS values, and you'll be left with just cosine of the phase shift between the voltage and the current. In summary, the power factor is defined as the real power over the apparent power. So think of our analogy to remember that. For a general periodic waveform, you have to find the average power over the period, and then you divide by the RMS value of the current times the RMS value of the voltage and solve for that. That will give you your power factor. For pure sinusoidal waveforms, it simplifies to something very nice. It's just the cosine of phi, where phi is defined as a phase shift between the voltage and the current. One last note is that the units for this will actually be unitless, and the maximum value will be 1, which is what you want, usually a high power factor near 1, and the lowest value would be 0.